beautiful morning. I want to tell you about the Hungarian livestock protection group named the Kuvas. And the name implies that of a guard or an archer. So that gives you some of its insight and its purpose. Its purpose breeds to protect, like a military type of protection given by a guard. And it's very alert for such a big breed. It is originally developed to be a guard of the royals, and later on being used more and more as a livestock protection breed. Currently it's mostly used as a pet, but still some are worked. It is a breed that resembles a lot the looks and feel of the Pyrenean mountain dog, although the Pyrenean mountain dog is more bulky and has more skin flaps. And also the Kuvas has a very light curl in its coat. So a faster type of dog, also having more stamina, less coat, so the coat is not as fluffy and thick, still thick enough for all conditions that you could use your dog in. Besides that, Kuvas are really nice type of dogs because they have a lot of patience. They are dogs not to be held for the novice unless properly. I think this thing about the novice, it is a dominant type of dog, of course, and if you don't know what you're dealing with, it's hard to make it work. But I'm not saying that it cannot be done. If you're serious about your thing and you really know what you're getting into, you can easily get the Kuvas as a first dog. But that means that you need to be serious and need to know what you're getting into. So also interact with adult dogs and see if you can handle them. And also know that you have to sacrifice more with some dogs, that they say they are not for the novice, as compared to other dog breeds. But if you do, you get a very big, strong dog that has that royal appearance, white coat, and a very nice character. And I would also recommend not to get it if you don't have a decent sized garden, because the Kuvas wants to do something, especially wants to guard. And if you have an apartment, there's nothing to guard, and the Kuvas will become a harder dog on you and your family, and also will destroy probably a lot of things and get other negative behavior traits which you don't like. With all dogs, should be kept supervised with children, but normally Kuvases are quite nice with them. The dog on the leash here is quite the opposite of the Kuvas. He's not white but black. He has not a rich coat but a short coat, and especially he's not a huge livestock protector breed, but a miniature livestock protector breed, because it doesn't protect the livestock when you were above ground but underground by doing terrier work, which means they go and knock on the door of the predator and try to halt it in any way possible so that it doesn't kill additional livestock. The breed purpose of the Kuvas is especially to protect the livestock against wolves and bears and that kind of predators, sometimes foxes, and also hawks can kill livestock, so that would also work. But this is a special type of dog, is bred to protect against foxes, badgers, and occasionally also used on above ground works, for example, hawk work, although it is too small a dog for doing this in the right way. Koevoosjes are, for the massive type of dog that they are, still fast, as I mentioned, which I really like. You can see similar breeds when you look at the Anatolian Shepherd breeds, the Kangal. They're also lighter on the feet than your average mastiff type of dog. And also they are quite long living, which is a big plus because most of the mastiff dogs don't live a long age, whereas Koevoosjes can reach 10 to 11 years regularly, which is a big plus. I mentioned the Kangal or other Anatolian Shepherd type of breeds, for example the Kurdish Mastiff, look a lot alike like the Koevoosjes. The head is a little bit stronger, and also the dogs can be a little bit bigger, but they're for similar purposes. They also call it the land breed, that in different regions, for example Turkey, the circumstances are different than, for example, Hungary, and they all prefer their own specific type, which is a subtype of the land race of the livestock protection breed. Then back to the origin, as a royal guard, this type of dog was developed to accompany and protect the houses of the royals when they went on trips or were living in their houses or sleeping in their beds, and to protect them and against both wolves, that they also do with the livestock, and bears, but also the two-legged ill-intent person that want to, for example, be a burglar or a killer or something else. Rapes were also a big problem at the time, and that the dog could help to prevent this by accompanying dames when they go for a walk or do something else. And also this is a dog that like most dogs, it's not only what they do, it's also what they prevent. So what I mean by this is, if you have a dog, there a lot of persons with ill intent will already think twice or three times or four times or five or ten times, it doesn't matter, before doing the things that they want to do. Whereas if you're walking alone, they wouldn't think that much, think it that much over and just do it. So the prevention is a big aspect, especially with this big type of dog. Also, if there is something happening, also someone with ill intent knows that often you can reason with a person to stop, to say, okay, it's over. But if a dog is winded up, the only one who can easily stop it, unless you are able to kill the dog, of course, is often the owner. And even the owner won't have an easy time. If he sees that the dog sees that you have been attacked by someone and he's taking care of it now, you bet that there will be serious consequences for the person that is lying on the ground. Because this is the type of dog that has the size, like all livestock protection breeds, and also the strength to work a man down. They call this man-stopping ability, which all mastiff types of dog have normally. But also the ferociousness, if put in that place, to do the things that he has to do. And you can imagine if that big jaws lock on and they break bones and can also rip throats very easily, which means a big trauma and big injuries, if not death. So that's also a thing that I meant when you're looking into such a dog. Big dogs mean big responsibilities. Not that they are vicious or have ill intent. No, I'm not referring to that. Of course, some dogs that are developed to protect will protect a lot better than dogs that haven't. But I mean, the size matters. Huh? If a dog like this, 12 kilogram, jumps towards you, it does nothing. And perhaps a child that can fall over by its force, but that's it. But if a dog of 60 kilograms or 40 kilograms or sometimes 80 to 100 kilograms, the livestock guardians get up to, that's the same. You will have probably a concussion by hitting the ground and hitting the back of your head to the stones. And then the rest will unfold. So please understand that if you have such a need, do what you want, but keep this in mind. Have a nice day.